Good morning, students. So today in this class we will learn about articles and its uses. So as I think all of you are aware of articles, there are two kinds of articles. One, indefinite article, another is definite article. When we move towards the table of indefinite articles, we have two there. One is A, another is N. And other side, on the table of definite articles, we have only one, the. It seems very easy, but it has a depth meaning of uses. If once we make a simple mistake to use any article, whole sentence will go wrong. So if we want to write or to speak correctly, we must know the proper use of article. As I have said you, okay, there are two kinds of article. One is indefinite, another is definite. On the table of indefinite, we have two articles, A and N. On the other hand, we have definite article, and on the table of definite article, we have only one, the. So, very first, indefinite article. There are two articles, A and N. So we have to learn the uses of A or N. So very first, we will learn the use of A. But I think before explaining these things, we must say one thing to you. The use of A or N. It is very clear that these two articles, A and N, are used before singular noun. It cannot be used before plural noun. It cannot be used before uncountable noun. So remember this point very first, ki it is always used before a singular noun, right? Next point is to understand, and that is, it is very common concept. If we need to use A or N, we have to focus on that word before which we are going to use A or N. If the initial sound of the word which is there is consonant or is vowel, no matter whatever be the letter, letter is not a term of consonant and vowel. Actually, the sound system is considered. If the initial sound of the word before which we are going to use A or N, we have to understand the sound of the initial word. If the initial word is consonant, we must use A there. If the initial sound of the word is vowel, must use N there. So initial sound is important. Letter is not important, whatever be the letter, because sometimes a consonant gives the sound of vowel and sometimes a vowel gives the sound of consonant. So it can make us confused. Therefore, it is very important that we must consider the initial sound of the word before we are going to use A or N. If the initial sound is consonant, A is used there. If the initial sound is vowel, N is used there. But now, once again, when we use A, we have to keep these points in our mind. And the point is very first, ki before a singular word that begins with consonant, as I have told you, the letter is not important. So you must take care of the initial sound. If the initial sound is consonant, must use A. For example, a cattle, okay? A cow. Because the initial sound of K is consonant here, therefore we use A. Next one, to before a word beginning with a vowel that gives a consonant sound. Once again, as I have told you, that some vowel gives the sound of consonant. So don't look into the letter. Try to understand the initial sound. If the sound is consonant, although the letter is vowel, you must use A. Like this, A union. You can see the word union starts from the letter U, undoubtedly letter U is a vowel, but it gives the initial sound U, that is consonant. Therefore, A is used. Now, the next step, third, with an expression of quantity, we use A. Whenever there is an expression of quantity, quantity means uncountable noun. Quantity is of uncountable noun. So, you can see a lot of time A is used here because the expression of quantity is expressed here. Now, number four, with certain numbers we use A. Like a 5 rupee note. Okay? Next one, keep before half, the word half, H-A-L-F, half. When it is, when it follows a whole number, half is used as a whole number. In that condition, we use A. Okay? Before half. Like this, one and a half. Here, half is used as a whole number. Therefore, I have used here A before half. But if the word half is not expressed as a whole, in such condition, we use A after the word half, like half a day. Now, about N. It is very simple, as I have told you, don't look into the letter, either it is consonant or vowel, but you have to focus on the initial sound of the word. If it is vowel, whatever be the letter, it doesn't matter. So you have to use N. Before a word beginning with a vowel, maybe vowel, but if it doesn't express the initial sound, you don't use N. But if it expresses the initial sound like a vowel, you must use like an aunt. Number two, before a word that begins with a silent H. Silent H means here, yes, in written we write a H, but we don't pronunciate it. It is known as silent. So when H is silented in pronunciation in a word, before that we write an, like an hour. And next one, ki before individual letters that have a vowel sound, maybe consonant. I once repeat, letter is not important. The important is initial sound. Letter may be of consonant, but it can give the sound of vowel. So we have to use an before that word, like an MA, like an SDO. Okay, so these are some uses of A and N. Now we have to move towards definite articles, the, where we can use the or where we don't. So very first we will learn to use the. So what are the rules for use of the? So very first usage of the, okay, number one, before we use the, before unique things like the sun, the moon, etc. The things which is only one that is unique, and we have to use definite article the before that things. Number two, when we refer to a particular, when we refer particular thing, we use the before that. When we refer to a particular thing, we have to use the. For example, you can see ki the Chandrayaan, went to the moon. Chandrayaan, it is particular thing, so we have to use the before that. And in very first point, I have explained about the unique things, the things which are only one in the world, that can be called unique. If there are so many things, that can't be unique. So like sun, like moon, like earth, okay. And when we refer to particular thing, we must use the before that word. Number three, before superlative degree, I have already explained in your previous classes. When we were talking about adjective, so there are 3 degrees of adjectives. Among them, one is the superlative degrees, and it is superlative degree of adjective is always used with definite article the tallest, the tallest, the best. Okay, are you getting or not? It is very easy to get. Now we use before proper nouns, before proper nouns, naming, before proper noun naming rivers, seas, island, mountain, special buildings, hotels, newspapers, and so other things, etc. So we use article the before names of the rivers, like the Ganga, the Jamuna, before seas, like the Hind Mahasagar, like islands, the Andaman Nicobar, mountain, before the names of mountains, the Himalayas, special buildings like Taj Mahal, the Golghar, hotels, the Taj hotels, newspapers, the Indian nation, etc. Okay? And yes, there are a few rules where we can't use definite article the. We can't use, and that is number one, you can say ki omission of article. Omission of articles. Omission of articles. Where we can't use article. Omission means don't use. As I have said you, okay, where we can use, where we don't. So now we are discussing about don'ts. That is omission of articles. We don't use article before proper noun, before uncountable noun, before names of days, months, before names of seasons, and this is how we can use article. So this is your summary about the omission of articles. We don't use article the before proper noun. We don't use before uncountable noun, sir. Before names of days, names of season, and we are always. So students, you have to write down each and everything in your grammar copy, because these are the most important topics to write English correctly and to speak English correctly, nothing should be. You have to go through the correct direction, learn, write and learn it. So it is all about the article. There are two types of article. One is indefinite, another is definite. On the table of indefinite, we have a and an. On the table of definite article, we have the. A is used before the word which has initial sound of consonant, and an before the word which has initial sound of vowel. Whatever be the letter, it doesn't matter. Don't look into the letter. Try to understand the initial sound. Otherwise, it will go wrong. And to use the, we have to remember the names of river, names of seas, names of mountains, names of oceans, names of islands, names of hotels, names of newspaper, names of magazines, names of special buildings, names of unique things. All those things are used, all those names are used with definite article the. So it is all about definite article. Now in next class we will learn another topic. Okay.